Today I'm going to teach you how to do the Smokey. The classic Smokey seems to be a popular one. I did it in class a few weeks ago, and all my friends are excited and like, oh, can you do the me? First thing you need to know is that when doing the Smokey, you need to use coal. Coal needs to be something that will smudge easily, it's black. When you're applying coal, you want to make sure that you do an even distribution across the lid. Otherwise, when you do your next layer, which is going to be an eyeshadow on top of the black, you're going to end up with an uneven distribution of eyeshadow. You're going to see what you're doing. And make sure you get right into the lash line, right into the crease. You want a very black. You see how black that goes? It isn't all that black if I didn't put the coal on underneath. Because the black shadow is sticking to the coal. And the coal, because it's black, is giving the eyeshadow depth. Whereas if I were to just put this on my wrist, it's a lot lighter. So for anyone who knows me in person or has been following my videos, you know that I'm already an artist, I'm already a painter, and I have 14 years experience, actually 15 years, in everything specialized, so body painting, theatrical makeup, face painting, whether it's kids or adults, what we call here in Quebec artistic maquillage, which is basically really classy, what I think is face painting for adults. Some people call it high fashion. Up until recently, I wasn't doing regular makeup. In September, I started a course to do regular makeup. So, all that said, I really enjoy working with things that I can use a paintbrush with. So what I'm using is Makeup Forever. It's the waterproof aqua black cream eyeshadow, but it's really great as a eyeliner. What I'm going to do is right underneath. was painting myself. So you see, I got a bit of a mess going, but don't worry, it's gonna work out. Now we're gonna do what is called the waterline. So that will be right here. I like using the waterproof because my eyes don't like this. I believe makeup is like chocolate. You have too much of a good thing. I don't wear makeup all the time, so when I put it on, sometimes my eyes get a little watery. I didn't do it ahead of time, but I should have. Take a setting powder and just put a lot of it right underneath your eyes. I know I look like I'm going to an Adam's Family ball, but believe me, this is professional. I don't know if you can see, but along with the exposed skin right here, what I want to do is cover that. Yes, I'm going into the waterline a bit. I'm using another makeup forever white cream eyeshadow as a base coat, and then I'm going to do white eyeshadow on top. Now it's time to work on cleaning this up. What I really need is a sponge, but I'm not with the right sponges, so I'm going to use this instead. What you want to do to figure out how far should your shadow go, how far I haven't done my eyebrows, but I'm going to do my eyebrows. How far should my eyebrows go? And it should be level with the concern of your nose, go all the way up like that. But that said, because this is such a dramatic look, and because it is intended for late evening and nighttime, it is something that you want to accompany with a heavy amount of foundation. I know it looks like it's super, super black, and that black on black isn't going to do any more. Blend out into more of a charcoal and kind of gray tone until you get to the white. You don't want to end up with a harsh line. So I really love iridescent shiny things, and I'm picking a lighter tone of black that's iridescent. I think just because I don't have a lot of space between my eye and my eyebrow, and I don't have a lot of space between my crease, my eyelash line and my crease, I need to bring down the white a little more to make the look work for my face. Is do another coat of mascara and bind my natural.